took him to number one in the world, stayed there for 36 weeks. Scottie Scheffler replaced him towards the end of March.
Yeah, this is 9-iron.
Not a bad way to start. Beautiful. Fairway, 9-iron, yeah, within 15 feet. It was some.
Oh. Starts left, not fading.
Yeah, I was just going to say, these guys are predominantly bad work, though. It's fine. That's absolutely fine.
Get up to that top level.
Yeah, just at 10%.
That's got to go. Another one that came out soft.
Yeah.
Out of that first cut.
Didn't fly out of there like he had to sort of protect against. Get a good look at the roll of the ball here.
Oh boy. Just a buck 50 and a great chance to attack here with a 9-iron, Trevor.
Yeah, absolutely accessible now. After that good tee shot.
Oh, trying to use the slope.
Needs to pick up some speed. It's trying. And that is a perfect picture for the amount of slope at this fourth green. Beauty. Rahm did his homework. Breathe on it. Hitting it so soft, that ball just snapped right across the hole.
Downwind, just cover it 290. As long as you get over those first couple of bunkers, Nick, I think you're okay. This one going left, though.
Yeah, well, it's nothing wrong with a stroke. You just try and get it just on an edge. It was a lot easier, that one, just right half.
And even though it was that short, it's probably a confidence builder for him, for sure.
Yeah.
Huge ridge in this green, running right back to that back left section. Trying to use that wind and fading. It's trying.
Well, he's hit the shot. Let's see how the reaction. That's wind makes all the difference. If it was going the other way, that would be impossible. Somewhere, and it just slows down the amount of break, or adds more.
Dribbled it out.
I thought two. I'm impressed with that. Making 2 on 6.
It's gettable, though.
Oh, it had a little bit, I believe. Yeah, he sure did.
You're right. He didn't want to go left there. That is a deep bunker over there. Incredible. Get there.
Oh, boy, that looked good.
Nestled amongst the neighborhood here in Brookline, we are watching Jon Rahm, the man who won the U.S. Open last year at one of the 2 par 5s. This is the 8th, a long attempt for eagle. And good pace from Rahm, who has looked solid thus far. That could get him to a tie for the lead. Rahm pours it in. So Jon Rahm's birdie 3 of the last 4. He's at 2 under par.
Good flag for Rahm here on the right hand side.
Don't plug.
He doesn't like it. This is a wipe.
Don't plug.
Don't plug yell right away. He knew it was bunker bound.
Really fast down here. This is complete defense, Mike. Just couldn't do much of that bunker shot on a downslope in the bunker. Short sighted.
I
left to the front right in this 10th green. And so left hole location. Wants to put
hard.
Something in the center of the green.
Very hard.
This is the second wipe in a row, guys. That was not solid and way out to the right and short. Pretty good lie here, Mike. I think you can kind of like a little controlled stab up the hill. Could work here.
That's well done. Left it below the hole there. Took care of the false front.
Sweeper from right to left.
Yeah, good effort. Almost got a little assist off the coin there.
Birdie finish a year ago at Torrey Pine to get it done.
I was covering that on feature groups coverage, and the electricity when those two putts went in.
Here's Jon Rahm, middle of the fairway now.
Now 147 and just a perfect 9-iron.
That's three in a row like that, man.
This is another weak one out to the right, guys.
And that's three recently.
That is.
Here's Jon Rahm just off the green at the 12th there.
Boy, good thing it's a good lie, because this is a touchy chip.
That's a touch of class there from Rahm.
All right, they'll head over to 13.
Kind of a high spot in the back part of this green, and then I think it's got a chance to move to the right as it loses pace.
Speed. Okay. So Rahm, it's a good approach. Finally hit a good solid one, but it was long.
Okay, you can see the slope that he's going there and then down the other side. Go a little bit to his right.
He was asking like, Aaron, where's that second break?
Yeah, right.
This is another flare.
I don't know what's going on. Every single time I try to do that.
There's something going on in that golf swing, guys, that he hasn't quite figured out yet.
All right, let's see what Jon Rahm can do with his third here at 15.
Boy, this is deep. This is just kind of an open club face stab.
It's going to put a little bit more pressure on that putter once again.
15.
Jon Rahm. Trying to remain under par.
Also similar line to Morikawa, needs that slope. This one might do it.
Higher apex, able to grab a little bit of that slope.
You know, we've talked and he's, you know, done all the commentary needed. Not pleased with his iron play, but he's at even par. At a U.S. Open, he's only three back. Well, maybe, no. Okay, so he's still three back. But he's hanging in there.
Right.
And he's got time this afternoon to go figure this out, get a little more comfortable with it. So he's putting together a good effort today, despite not being completely pleased with his game.
Great angle in the rough, so he doesn't have to worry about spinning off that ridge. He can actually bounce it up there. That might have to go a little bit.
Might go in. So if he can escape with a three here. Take a look at that respect on the speed.
Boy, this one started way left.
Four left!
Not cutting.
Oh, that is way over there. That's your broadcast position. there. Paul Azinger, who's going to be in here with Dan Hicks in about an hour and 40 minutes when we flip over to NBC.
Stay up. Yes, it does. Oh. That is a really, really gutty 69 right there by Jon Rahm.